our societal challenges are large, often touching millions and even a billion people. We live in a world where there are many simultaneous and diverse issues of society, of the economy, politics, demography, all of them happening at the same time. We deal with change, rapid change in our lives brought upon by migration, globalization, and technology. And we have complex interfaces between public, private, and social systems. When we look at this complex mosaic, individual solutions to individual problems really don't have much of an impact. They make a difference to a small set of people in a small way. But to bring about large systemic change, you need a much more strategic and catalytic approach. And that is a new way of doing things.
We're calling this evolving new approach, this new way of thinking and doing together, societal platform thinking. So this idea of societal platforms has come to us from our separate work and the work we are doing together at Ek Step 2. For example, my work at Pratham Books, where we try to make sure that every child had a book in her hand. And of course, Nandan's work at a population scale with Aadhaar, and some of the other work we have done in our careers. This thinking has emerged from that because it's obvious that we need more than the sum of every part. It's not just that, we have built these ideas and this evolving approach with our own teams, and it's not just us and our teams. This idea of societal platforms is also inspired by and synthesized by looking at tremendous work done by leaders, thinkers around the world who have also tried to solve very complex societal problems, thinking that they must be addressed at the right scale, that they must be looked at with urgency, and most importantly, they must be done in a way which will last and not break down soon. So they must be, as Nandan says, done with speed, at scale, and they must be done in a societally sustainable manner.
It is important to start with the right mission and goals. It's only by asking the right questions and seeking the right answers that societal challenges can be dealt at scale, speed, and in a sustainable fashion. For example, how do you give 1 billion Indian residents a unique identity that can be authenticated anywhere, anytime? Or how can you enhance learning opportunities for 200 million children by 2020? Another example, how can we ensure affordable credit to 100 million first-time borrowers within 5 years? Or it can be, how do we ensure 2,000 cities have modern governance by 2020? It's only when we define an ambitious and broad sweep of mission and change that we want that we'll get the answers to achieve the goals for speed, scale, and sustainability.
So when we talk of real societal problems, those in health, those in education, those facing the environment, and so many other things about equity and opportunity for billions of people, we know that we can't think and do in silos. We know that no single actor or even a group of actors can actually address these by themselves. So we need the continuum of Samaaj, Bazaar and Sarkaar to work on these issues. Samaj and societal institutions, including just citizens like all of us, Bazaar, which means the market has to play a role, and of course the state, which is eventually the biggest leverager and the biggest enabler of scale. It's when all of us can work together seamlessly that I think we might be able to address issues at the scale and the level at which they need to be addressed. So how do we do all this? I think it's important to have a core philosophical value. And we believe that societal platforms need to be obviously open, transparent structures. The infrastructure must be created as a public good. That's very important. We also need to make sure that that infrastructure allows us all to co-create and to collaborate as seamlessly as possible. Obviously, this platform, this infrastructure must allow actors, all those who care about creating a positive outcome to work together, the Samaj, the Bazaar and Sarkaar, together and separately. And obviously, if we are going to do this, we need to harness the latest evolving technologies in their best possible way. And finally, we need data to emerge from this so that we know we are on the right path and can do course correction. So enabling data engines to work on this platform are very important too.
Societal platform thinking is one of the ways forward. It includes creating a light and agile digital infrastructure on which you can co-create, and many people with a common shared purpose, be it governments, entrepreneurs or social organizations, can come together. It's about taking scarce resources and making them abundant and making them available as public goods that can be used in different contexts. And finally, it's about social, private and public actors amplifying these resources, leveraging the platform so that it can reach millions of people. Unlike a commercial platform that is a private venture, a societal platform is designed to serve the public good. The value that is created is distributed to all the users and stakeholders of the societal platform, unlike a commercial platform where the value is captured by the owners. And a societal platform does not create dependency, but enables the participants to co-create and transform and iterate all the solutions that they have in mind.
Let's try to flesh out this concept we are talking about by using examples from our own work at Ekstep. The vision there was, what can we do to increase learning opportunities for 200 million children of this country in the next 5 years? That's how ambitious it was. To do that, we had to unpack a lot of things happening in the education sector. And we started to build out toolkits that those who are already working there could use to enhance their own capabilities. So that first elegant, simple digital layer included toolkits for, say, content creators. Anybody, and in education, everyone needs to create content. So toolkits for them to be able to create better content. And now, anybody in the education sector can use those toolkits to do more content-aware creation. So for example, somebody can build math worksheets, math videos, or anything that creates very good capability to learn math using those toolkits from that bottom layer. So now someone, say a teacher, needs to create math content. So her situation is more context aware. So you can use those toolkits to create much better math worksheets, for example. And that's what we are calling the second layer, the context aware layer. So those toolkits can be used for something specific like math. And finally, for the amplification layer, we can go to even more context specificity. So for example, say the Tamil Nadu government wanted to deploy this math curriculum in Tamil across the state. That's the power of the platform, that it will allow them to do this and scale it up rapidly. And so we are very interested to see if others can join us to take this idea to the other sectors where there are tremendous problems, just beyond education. If you look at water, livelihoods, financial inclusion, any environmental issues, healthcare, we think there's a kernel there which will allow this idea to be explored in other sectors as well. When we try to unpack the problems in those sectors, we often will arrive at something common that needs to be deployed so that everybody working on those problems can use certain common shared infrastructure to deliver what they are best at delivering to solve this problem in their own way. So what we can do is to create a unified infrastructure, a unified and shared infrastructure, but not a uniform one. Because in India, if we have learned anything, is that there is richness and diversity everywhere, and people know how to solve their own problems in their own context the best. As in India, so in the world. We know that the same problems manifest in all parts of this diverse globe. In our interactions, Nandan and I have met some really amazing people, leaders, thinkers, successful people who have solved problems in their own way at scale. I know that we face the same issues. How can we expand the work we are doing to address the problem at the scale required? We hope that people and thinkers and leaders from around the globe can also join us in this journey and help us enhance what we are doing, help us scale up what we are doing, help us learn from them and inspire us to do better in India, and hope that we can take some of these experiments to other parts of the world.
What does it take to think the societal platform way? It takes extreme risk capital, distributed leadership, being ideology agnostic, deep technology, and sustained ownership. Above all, it requires a determined system leader who looks at all the players in the ecosystem in a holistic manner, be it government, private entrepreneurs, or social organizations, and brings them all together to align for a common goal. We have embarked on this exciting journey to develop and apply the idea of societal platforms. It is early days yet, but we are seeing tremendous opportunity to apply this thinking to various societal challenges so that they can be addressed at speed, scale, and in a sustainable way.
And so we really hope that you will join us in this journey so that we can exercise our collective imagination and our creativity to look at new ways, important new ways of solving old complex challenges. I know we all care about making a difference to the societies we live in, and let's do this together and let's begin to address those enormously complex and real and urgent problems that we see around us. Thank you.